Hey CM friends, Dave, and I've got another story for you today. This one happened a bunch of years ago when I was the program director at Covenant Pines Bible Camp way up in northern Minnesota. I remember one time I left my house in the morning, went over to work at my office, and was heading back home for lunch. And as I got to the house, I opened the door and I was surprised by the fact that the screen door part of our sliding glass door was laying on the floor with big claw marks in it. And I thought to myself, I can't believe it. My boss's dog, Lady, must have knocked the door down and gotten into the kitchen and gotten something. I was super frustrated, and I remember taking the door, putting it back on, and then heading back over to work. Well, end of the day comes, and as I'm heading back, I realize that my wife, Kristen, had come home. She was in the house, and I opened the door, and she said, Dave, what happened? Why is the screen door laying on the floor with all these marks on it? And sure enough, again, the screen door was laying on the floor. And I said, I'm not sure, but I think that lady, I think Bruce's dog, knocked the screen door down again. And then my wife looked at me, and she goes, I'm not sure, Dave, if it was Lady, because, and then she held up a bag that held this kind of gort mix with it had peanuts and raisins and M&Ms in it, this kind of bag mix, trail mix. She held this trail mix bag up and it was shredded. I mean, like something had just woofed into it. And she said, I think some animal might have gotten into here and gotten into the gort mix. And we walked around back of the house, and sure enough, just on the edge of the property was a bear. And it came to our attention. We said, my goodness, this bear has been inside of our house twice. And my wife goes, yeah, he was coming into the kitchen to get the food that we'd left there. I didn't know what to do. So I told my wife, you know, get in the car. Bring the car over here. I went in the house and I got my shotgun and I loaded it up with some trap shot and a couple buckshot. And I went over to my car and I took the sunroof out and I got into the car and my wife drove and I stood out of the sunroof with the gun and we went towards the bear, kind of like a tank. And we kept thinking the bear would run. And then I remember shooting two shots over the bear's head and finally the bear ran off into the woods. And we never forget that. And I remember it was just days before kids were gonna be coming to camp. So we had to get the DNR in. We had to do whatever we could to trap this bear. I'll never forget that fact that bear had been in my house. And I was wondering to myself, why would the bear go in there? And the answer to that is pretty simple. I left stuff out that lured the bear inside. I sometimes think about that. And I think about that and I look at my life. And I say, man, there are some things in my life that I'm not sure how they got there. But when I really think about it, and I think about the things I've been watching and the things I've been doing, I realize that I've invited those things into my life. I want to make a challenge to you. It's a new semester. We can make some changes, but look at your daily life. Look at your attitudes. Look at the things that are inside of you, and particularly the things that you wish weren't inside of you. And ask yourself the question, am I inviting those things in by the things I'm watching, by the things I'm doing, by the people I'm with? Am I inviting those things into my life? Pray that God will point out areas in your life that you need to strengthen up and that he will point out to you the things that you need to steer away from to make this semester an awesome semester for you, to keep the bears out from the inside. That's my word for you. God bless and have an amazing week and an amazing beginning to the new semester.